وَإِذْ تَقُولُ لِلَّذِي أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَأَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْسِكْ عَلَيْكَ زَوْجَكَ وَاتَّقِ اللَّهَ وَتُخْفِي فِي نَفْسِكَ مَا اللَّهُ مُبْدِيهِ وَتَخْشَى النَّاسَ وَاللَّهُ أَحَقُّ أَنْ تَخْشَاهُ فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِّنْهَا وَطَرًا زَوَّجْنَاكَهَا لكي لا يكون على المؤمنين حرج في أزواج أدعيائهم إذا قضوا منهن وطرا وكان أمر الله مفعولا. This is a deep ayah which is not easy to explain, but it carries a very powerful concept in our iman and our faith. So as Muslims, we all know that the Quran is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is nothing but a messenger who is communicating those words for us. In fact, other ayahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in other ayahs, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَوِيلِ, if he forged statements in our name, لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ, we would take him off in his right hands violently, ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ, we would cut off his main artery. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam cannot forge or add or edit anything from the Quran. And this ayah is one of those proofs. This ayah is portraying one of those uncomfortable moments in the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So much so that if it was up to him, no man would appreciate his personal life and matters to be displayed in public like this. Aisha radiallahu anha says, if Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam were to hide anything from the revelation, he would have hidden this ayah. So here's some background. Zayd bin Haritha used to be a slave before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam freed him and adopted him as a son. This was done based on the customs of Jahiliyyah, the period of ignorance before Islam. And this was before, of course, the revelation of the Quran. Later on, Islam made adoption prohibited in this same surah, Surah Al-Ahzab. In another occasion, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded Zayd to marry Zaynab bin Jahsh, who was his cousin. And the two got married, and less than a year into the marriage, they started having issues in that marriage. And this ayah was revealed to comment on that incident. وَإِذْ تَقُولُ لِلَّذِي أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Remember Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what you said to Zayd, who was blessed by Allah with Islam and with companionship to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you favored him by freeing him from slavery. أَمْسِكْ عَلَيْكَ زَوْجَكَ وَاتَّقِ اللَّهِ. Stay with your wife, hold on to your marriage, and be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتُخْفِي فِي نَفْسِكَ مَا اللَّهُ مُبْدِيهِ. Ya Muhammad, you are hiding and concealing in yourself that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make manifest. You did fear the people, whereas Allah deserves more to be feared than the people. Allahu Akbar. See these powerful words that Allah is speaking to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here Allah is telling His beloved Messenger, don't be concerned with what people say, and don't fear the people, and fear Allah instead. We see the human element of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the divine revelation telling him what to do. فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِنْهَا وَطَرًا زَوَّجْنَاكَهَا. So when Zayd and Zaynab got separated, and by the way, Zayd is the only Sahabi who was mentioned by name in the whole Quran, subhanAllah. So when they got divorced and Zaynab's duration, the iddah, was expired, Allah married Zaynab to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. زَوَّجْنَاكَهَا لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ حَرَجٌ فِي أَزْوَاجِ أَدْعِيَائِهِمْ. We married her to you, and the reason was stated clearly. They won't be upon the believers any discomfort in marrying the wives of their adopted sons after they divorce them, because they are not your sons anymore, basically. This is yet another example to the countless proofs that the Quran could have never been forged by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why would the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teach his followers such private details about his life, especially knowing the culture of ghira, the protective jealousy that they had, where nobody would like to share these intimate details about their lives? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us, you know, the beauty of the Quran, and help us base our iman, our conviction, our faith in Islam based on strong foundations of knowledge, not only a spiritual experience. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.